Will Allen is my guest, UFO expert. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am Sean Anthony, the hip hop motivator, your host. Let's go to line two. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Hello. Hello. You're on. Oh, they got scared. Line four. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio. This is Sean Anthony. Hello.
Yeah. I have a question for him, and I want to make a statement. My statement is, it's kind of strange that the United States actually are hiding the information from the from the citizens. But Great Britain, I believe, last year, they publicly opened up all their records to the public because they had so many phone calls and so many things happened that people were blocking the phone lines. So they couldn't do anything. So they were like, fine, we're just going to open it up so everybody can see. But the U.S. is scared because they believe that it's going to be anarchy and people are just going to, you know, riot and go crazy. And my question is, I personally feel that what happened in Jerusalem of the orb coming down, making a bright flash and going back up, it also happened in D.C. and over the White House and a couple of other places years back. I personally think that it seems that it might be pretty much, I want to say, like, they're taking photographic pictures and x-ray scans of our significant areas. And I just wanted to know, how did he feel about that as well?
Will, did you hear that question?
I agree. I think that what's happening is, first of all, by them showing themselves like that is letting us know that they're here, first of all. That's one of the things that they're doing. And secondly, they're observing our actions. And it's funny that it just would happen to take an event over Mecca and Jerusalem to make some of this at least hit home on some of the folks that witnessed this event, and that here in Washington, D.C., on July the 20th in 2010, over the White House, I photographed a luminous white object with red and blue spheres that were moving in tandem formation that were pursuing what looked like a spirit in the sky. And this luminous UFO projected a plasma beam towards the spirit, trying to scoop it up out of the sky, but the spirit seemed to outmaneuver the objects that were pursuing it. So, to me, everything this lady is describing and everything that most people have seen, which is being documented right now, is taking place right now, are events that are meant for us to see. Mm-hmm. And they want us to see these things. That's why these things are showing up in my photographs.
Absolutely. Thank you for listening, and I appreciate your call.
No problem.
All right. Will, I'm going to play a clip from Fox News in Orlando of some sightings that happened in January. So take a listen to this.
UFO sightings are skyrocketing in 2012. Eyewitnesses reporting strange things in 36 out of the 50 states. And yeah, Florida's included. We are joined on the phone right now, Peter Davenport from he's the director of the UFO Center there in Washington. Peter, let me tell you something. Everybody's got a cell phone camera these days. I'm imagining if you're having a lot of sightings, you're getting some pretty good pictures.
Well, we got some pictures, but the overwhelming majority of them are of low quality, as you say, from those cell phones. What we encourage people to do if they see what they think may be a UFO is try to get a good camera, stabilize the camera no matter what they're using, and try to get a good still photo of it. Just before this program, I reviewed our database. We took 110 reports on New Year's Eve. 13 of them are from Florida. And something is going on. I think it's picked up dramatically, the number of reports we're receiving.
Peter, I've always wished that I could see a UFO. Have you ever in your life seen one?
I have. In fact, I saw a doozy of a sighting here out in eastern Washington I think it was the 17th of October last year, 2011. I was out for a walk on our local golf course and saw something go over at 6:42 p.m., for which I have absolutely no explanation. I've been a commercial pilot for the last 33 years, and I've never seen anything like that.
Will Allen, did you are you familiar with that gentleman, Peter Davenport?
I'm very familiar with Peter, and I've sent Peter several samples. And in some cases, not all the cases, Peter will conclude that those objects are not extraterrestrial in nature. And one of the things that he concluded was not were the samples taken at the U.S. Capitol building in 2002. So, you know, in lieu of everything, and so he may not necessarily agree with a lot of the samples that he sends, and I use high-definition cameras, so my pictures didn't fall into the category of the low-quality, low-resolution image samples.
Right.
Of all of the samples that I submitted, and especially the photographic evidence that I'm able to capture with my own camera, of all of the samples that I submitted, other people, not necessarily at my point of view from where I've taken these photographs, but other people in the area, especially like the sample I took in Baltimore in 2008, witnessed same objects that I photographed, also describe the objects that I photographed with a level of professionalism that would easily be, when translated, if you read what they wrote and if you looked at the photographs that I took, you would easily say, okay, here is what they're talking about. So you have people from different places and different locations during the time of a close encounter or an alien event, which just happens to take place, that witness these things, and all the evidence goes to Peter's website, and I'm able to take Peter's website and substantiate everything that I have with reports, not necessarily from what I've taken with my own camera, but with reports at the same time, in the same locations, in the same areas in which I take these photographs. Now, July the 16th, 2002, at the U.S. Capitol building, I photographed luminous green spheres in the air, landing and stationary at the Capitol building. 4 days later, a person and his wife at the U.S. Capitol building just happens to see a green fireball fly by the Capitol dome. So we're getting all of this information and putting all of these pieces of information together and concluding based on the physical evidence that obviously something did take place. And the physical evidence that I'm able to gather with my camera and the physical evidence that I'm able to gather from Peter Davenport's Newport website confirms everything that I have. So there's nothing that I have that's fictitious.
Well, I don't doubt you, Will. I definitely don't doubt you. I'm going to try to take one more call, one last call, because we are running out of time. Let's go to line three, Floor Wisdom Radio. This is Sean Anthony. Hello?
Hi, can y'all hear me?
Yes. Be very brief, please.
All right. I just wanted to ask Mr. Allen, does he feel that since science is kind of deciphering most of the religious phenomenon to be a natural phenomenon, then people are switching to the idea that possibly everything that we read in the Bible or Quran or any other religious books are aliens? So my question is, are people now realizing that religion is not true and they're looking for a second answer?
I believe that that's what's happening right now. And, you know, when you start looking at people who are yearning for the truth of the matter, and we're taught and we're fed information to believe that we're the only intelligent life form in this galaxy, and we're the only possibility of thought that could possibly exist within reason on this planet, it's absurd for us to even think that we're the only intelligent life force that could possibly exist anywhere. So, yeah, I have a problem with people who try to translate what I take photographs of as something that could possibly be demonic or religious in text, which it's not. I'm photographing unusual airborne anomalies. That's it. I can't say that they're religious. I can't say that they're evil. I can't say they're demonic. I can't say they're here to take over. I can't say anything like that because none of my samples have been hostile.
Will Allen,
Will,
thank you once again for coming back on. And if you get any new breaking information, feel free to call in, you know, let me know and I'll put you on the program. Any last minute words from my listeners? How can they get in contact with you? How can they see your information?
They can get in contact with me through my website at UFODC at UFODC.com. And definitely check out UFODC.com, my website, because I update it daily with information and updates. There are 15 chapters there. Definitely stuff worth looking into. Nothing fictitiously generated, nothing that's ominous. I don't give anybody any false prophecies. I just show you straight up UFOs.
Well, thank you. So much, man. I appreciate it. And I'll talk to you soon.
Sean, thanks for having me.
Not a problem. You can get more information on Will Allen. Go to flowofwisdom.com. I'll just encourage you to live life, get wisdom, and let it flow. I'm going to ride out to Nas, a song called We Are Not Alone. And this is our former president, Ronald Reagan, speaking about UFOs. Good day.
It will be safer and more secure for you and your children. I couldn't help at one point in our discussions with privately with General Secretary Gorbachev. When you stop to think that we're all God's children, wherever we may live in the world, I couldn't help but say to him, just think how easy his task and mine might be in these meetings that we held if suddenly there was a threat to this world from some other species, from another planet, outside in the universe. We'd forget all the little local differences that we have between our countries, and we would find out once and for all that we really are all human beings here on this earth together. Well, I don't suppose we can wait for some alien race to come down and threaten us, but I think that between us, we can bring about that realization. Thank you all. God bless you all.